Welcome to worship and Happy New Year. Today is the first day of 2023 and we meet with all the anticipation and dread that brings. But we meet in the hope and belief that whatever 2023 holds for us, Emmanuel, God with us, is here and that as part of the body of Christ we are supported and loved. It's over. Last year is gone. Our words, our thoughts, our deeds are in the past. Today we begin anew. Today and every day, God offers us life and hope. Here, now, forever, we are forgiven and healed. This year, let us live as such people. Thanks be to God. Let us worship God. The New Year by Ella Wheeler Wilcox. What can be said in New Year rhymes that's not been said a thousand times? The New Year's come, the old years go. We know the dream, we know. We rise up laughing with the light. We lie down weeping with the night. We hug the world until it stings. We curse it then and sigh for wings. We live, we love, we woo, we wed. We wreathe our prides, we sheet our dead. We laugh, we weep, we hope, we fear. And that's the burden of a year. Let us pray. God of yesterday, today and tomorrow, we gather this first Sunday of the new year in a mixture of hope, anticipation, fear, excitement and expectation. We do not know what the year holds for us. There are things we are afraid of, worries about health and family, job security and finances. There is much to look forward to, weddings or anniversaries or baptisms, holidays to enjoy, friends to laugh with. But whatever the year holds for us, we place every day of this year in your care, knowing that, as in the past, you are with us, caring for us with constant love. God of wisdom and truth, at the beginning of this new year, we look back and we look forward. In the year that's passed, we experienced joy and we experienced sorrow. We felt blessed and we felt challenged. Some things went by much too fast, and some things lingered far too long. Here in this space, we are reminded that you are present through it all. We are reminded that we are never alone. We are reminded that nothing can separate us from your love. So, at the beginning of this new year, we pause now in silence to reflect on the year that has passed. We remember the things from the past year which we are most thankful for. We can recall the moments we were the happiest. We consider the times we felt most alive. We recognise the times we gave and received the most love. We are grateful, God, that you were present in those times. We also remember the things from this past year that we are least thankful for. We recall the moments when we were the least happy. We consider the times we felt life draining from us. We recognise the times we gave and received the least love. We are grateful, God, that you were present in those times too. Gracious God, at the beginning of this new year, we are confident that you will be with us still, when we are thankful and when we are not, when we are happy and when we are sad, when we feel alive and when we feel drained, when we give and receive love and when we do not. God, the world we live in is messy and challenging. It is the world of King Herod, a world of pain, a world of doubt, a world of fear, a world of jealousy, a world of violence, a world of domination, a world of injustice, a world of human feelings. Yet, God, you are always with us. So give us grace and give us courage to live truthfully in this imperfect world. Remind us always of the promise of your kingdom emerging around us and through us. And it's for this kingdom that we now pray, using the words Jesus taught us, saying, Our Father, who's in heaven, holy be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us in the time of trial, and deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and the glory, now and forevermore. Amen.
Luke chapter 2, verses 16 through to 21. So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told to them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. Well, Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Jesus presented to the temple. On the eighth day, when it was time to circumcise him, he was named Jesus, the name the angel had given him before he had been conceived.
At our service in King Street UF Church before Christmas, we had a quiz on what was really in the Christmas narratives that we are given in the Bible. Out go the number of wise men, the animals in the stable, the innkeeper, even that little donkey giving Mary respite from walking. And I've just finished a book called The First Christmas, which talks about the differences in the two versions of the nativity story we have. One in the Gospel of Matthew, one in the Gospel of Luke. And what might have been the reason for these differences. Next week is Epiphany, when we'll be thinking about the wise men and their gifts that are mentioned in the Gospel of Matthew. But for this week, we go with the Gospel of Luke's story of the shepherds finding Jesus, the fact that Jesus' parents followed the Jewish practice of getting him circumcised at 8 days old, and that Mary began her treasure store of memories of all the extraordinary things that were now happening to her family. In some Christian traditions, the 1st of January is time spent thinking about the meaning of Jesus' name. As we heard read, he was named by his parents and the priest 8 days after his birth, with the name the angel told Mary he was to be called when he, the angel, appeared months before. The name Jesus means one who saves, or saviour. And in 1st century Palestine, we'd have indicated that this child would grow up to help his people escape the oppression they were living under. Somehow, Jesus would bring freedom from the Romans' rule over his people. How important are our names to us? Do we use the name our parents gave us, or have our names changed as we've grown older, either by us or by schoolmates or workmates? What name would we like to be called? In the book of Revelation, the writer says that God will write our name on a white stone, a reference to a Roman custom of giving victors in sporting competitions a white stone inscribed with their name, which allowed them entry to a special winner's banquet. Each of our names is written on a virtual stone today, being used to build a church. We are, as the writer of the first letter of Peter says, like living stones, being built into a spiritual house, becoming God's holy priesthood. And so we are encouraged to be like the shepherds, telling out the story of the angel's message, like Mary, remembering the touch of God in our lives. Being one of God's people, may we, as our prayer will suggest, not keep our blessings to ourselves, but give them away, so that others we meet might learn of God's love, so that children might be fed, so that bridges might be built, and so that God's hope may flow into the world.
Revelation chapter 21, verses 1 through to 6. The New Jerusalem. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Now the dwelling of God is with men, and he will live with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death, or mourning, or crying, or pain. For the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." He said to me, "It is done. I am the Alpha and the Omega, the beginning and the end. To him who is thirsty, I will give to drink without cost from the spring of the water of life."
Got your list done? I've been working on my list of New Year resolutions. Walk more, sleep more, read more, go outside more. And you know what I noticed? It's the same list I had last year and the year before and the year before that. What, if any, resolutions have you made this year? It does tend to be always the same old things that we work at improving, instead of maybe adding a new thing to our lists, an activity we've never tried, an event we've never attended, that place we've never visited. Do we fall into the trap of thinking God uses the same list year after year? Do we think that God will always do the things the way they've always been done? Our New Testament lesson today reminds us that God is in the business of newness, new heaven, new earth, new Jerusalem, new me, new you. And that shouldn't surprise us. Scripture makes it clear that God is always willing to risk, to dare, to think and do outside the box, to do something, to do everything new. And God wants us to be open to that new thing offered to us, to that new person who will enhance our life, to that new challenge which will make us grow, to that new opportunity we will have to serve. For the congregation of my church, Tayport Parish Church, we begin our new journey united with Leuchars St Athanase today, and the challenge of the new is upon us. We successfully formed a new bond with Tayport United Free Church 2.25 years ago. We enjoy working with the other Christian denominations in Tayport, and now we're making an even larger church family in our area. But wherever you are, whatever new thing God is offering to you this year, may we all be more open to what God is doing among us. It's only through us working together as the body of Christ that the good news of Emmanuel, God with us, can be told and shown to our world. New year, time to make way for the new, dream afresh, embrace new joys and embark on new voyages. May you know God with you as you journey through 2023.
Glorious Lord, Emmanuel.
New Year's prayer. Quietly, the New Year slips in. Are we now more fearful? The radio asks. More careful? More tired? Are we now more aware of the suffering, the violence, the inequality, the injustice in our world? We seek God as we have always sought God. We long for God's presence, God's peace, God's justice and God's love in our world. Can we hear and see Jesus in our neighbour, in the foreigner, in the refugee, even in our enemy, and perhaps especially in ourselves? Can we know in the deepest part of ourselves that we are called and capable of seeing and naming, doing and being God's love, God's peace, God's hope and God's justice in this world? Let us pray. Holy God, at the dawn of a new year, we are gathered to worship and listen. Listen for your voice calling us to something new. In the wake of Advent, Christmas and the turn of the new year, some of us are still hopeful and full of expectation. Some of us are weary and worn. Some of us are overwhelmed and anxious. But as sure as the sun rises, a new year is upon us, full of possibilities, full of promise. You are a God of newness and change, and you call us to be continually transformed. In this season of resolve, help us to be mindful and intentional about our priorities. Help us to look to Jesus as our way. Help us to rely on the Spirit to follow in our faith and in our doubt. Inspire us with a vision of the world as it could be, a world closer to your intentions and desires, a world of abundance and plenty, a world of peace and security, a world of cooperation and prosperity, a world of health and well-being, a world of love and justice. In some ways, it's easy at the beginning of a new year to be idealistic and zealous, to be bold in our dreams and resolutions. So God, we ask that you help us to be patient and disciplined, persistent and steady throughout the entire year. Maybe not too quickly fall back into familiar habits and patterns. Maybe not lose hope or vision. May we be your kingdom people each and every day of this new year. God, even as we hope and dream of a better world, even as we make plans to be better people, we are mindful of the realities that face us right now. So we ask for healing and wholeness for those who are sick. We seek comfort for those who are grieving. We pray for companionship for those who are lonely, those who need jobs and homes and food, and we long for peace in places of war. We desire justice for those who are oppressed. We want reconciliation for those who are estranged. We are confident, God, that you will walk with us as we strive to meet these needs. We are confident that you will walk with us always. Your presence among us is abiding and real. Your love fills our lives and guides our paths. Help us, God, to not put Christmas away too quickly, to enjoy the fullness of this season and be transformed by the Spirit of Christ in our midst. May we not keep our blessings, but give them away, so that others might learn new dance steps, so children might be fed, so bridges might be built, and so grace may flow to all in your world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Once again, it's been a privilege to share worship with you. This week, may we accept God's gifts in our lives and use them to feed the hungry, clothe and shelter the poor, welcome the outcast and alienated. And at the beginning of this new year, may we boldly use the gifts of God to dismantle systems which oppress God's children and to create systems that lead to peace. And now a blessing. Let us look for Christ wherever we go. Let us never stop seeking, believing that there is a light that shines in the darkness, which the darkness shall not overcome. And may the love of the Creator, the joy of the Spirit, and the peace of the Christ child be with us this new year and forevermore. Amen.